I never had a good education. I'd have never made it to university. I've had to teach myself.
You've got to be here somewhere. I've shown you UFO stuff, footprints.
There's only one word for me, I suppose. I'm a genius.
What's it? What's it? What's it? Aha!
Anyway, let's do this interview. Hello, I'm Rex Gilroy, the Yowie Man. I'm almost 70 years old and I've been researching the Yowie for the last... How long have I been doing it? Hang on. I've been doing this research into the Yowie for some 56 years now. In China, of course, they call them the Yeren there, the Almastis in Russia. In North America, the Bigfoot. And in New Zealand, they have the Moihau. But they all mean basically the same thing, wild man or wild hairy people or hairy people or hairy men, hairy women. Scientists said it was just a mythical creature like the bunyip. Of course, we've gone out looking for these so-called myths and we found the evidence. I went out here into the Blue Mountains scrubland and I started to find things. My collection is priceless. I must be the only researcher in Australia who's got fossil human skulls under their dining room table. I have fossils from every geological period of the Earth's history, and I now have the largest privately owned natural science collection in Australia.
Yes.
Over the years, we have amassed a huge collection, so much so that we're virtually living in a pocket of our home and the rest of it's the collection, whether it be books or whether it's rocks and other artifacts and things like that.
I'm so cramped for space lately. I'm at the stage where I've got to find room for them.
With Rex's theories, I've always supported him, and in actual fact, I'm probably his biggest skeptic, because I'm asked questions. How do you know that? And why do you think that's an artifact and that sort of thing? And he then explains it to me.
Yes, Heather is very important to my research and my life generally. We're soul brothers, you can say. We're a team. Some people call us Mr. and Mrs. Yowie or Mr. and Mrs. Indiana Jones. I do have an Indiana Jones hat and I wear that whenever I'm in the bush. Might as well dress the part.
I was interested in history, historical stuff, but no, I'd probably never even heard of a Yowie before I met Rex. It hasn't been easy. We didn't know what the problem was at the time, but now that we know that it's Asperger's.
That's stupid. Put up. I had it in hands.
And I'm the one with the feet on the ground. I'm the one, the practical person. I'm the one that does the cooking, the cleaning, the everything else.
Well, what have I done? Oh, thanks.
Throughout the world, there's vast areas of land that man can't get into. In such regions, any animal unknown to science could quite easily survive without us knowing. The scientist said to me once, it's impossible. That's a word found in the dictionary of fools as far as I'm concerned. But I need physical proof. I need tissue. I need a freshly dead corpse or hair samples or a skeleton, a skull. Something physical that a biologist can work with. And that's what I'm searching for.
Something's been here. Could be a Yowie. Yeah.
So far, there is not one authentic still photo of a Yowie. For some reason, they don't trust man, and I don't blame them. The
results of a lifetime's dedication.
Everything I've discovered has come the hard way. I haven't had any funding from anyone. And here I am, almost 70, and I don't know what I'm going to do with the collection. That's the one problem I got. They've got to go back in the garage.
I know it's worth a couple of million dollars, but my lifetime's notes, preserved in hundreds of exercise books, would be worthless in their eyes because I'm not a trained scientist. Being an amateur, I haven't got the ability, it seems, to observe and record things properly like a scientist. I beg to differ there. But the bulk of my collection, because I'm an amateur, would be destroyed. I've been told that. And that's part of my life. And without it, I'd have nothing to live for. Yeah. Yeah. Love me or hate me, I am that rare phenomenon in world history, a genius. A genius, still broke. We have this hidden history, as I say, that will become accepted in years to come. And I'll be known as the pioneer of that, I guess. Rex Gilroy is being laughed at the moment. But 100 years from now, people will think more kindly of me, I hope.